I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end.
Welcome back, folks. When we left off, we had just arrived at Megaton after cleaning out Springvale School. Been looking forward to this. This is my favorite, one of my favorite places in the game, and often ends up kind of being the hub of all my activities, buying, selling. It's got my favorite house in it, lots of cool characters, tons and tons of quests. So for the next little bit, this is probably going to be the eye of the storm here, because there's so many quests branch out from Megaton. So we're going to get to know this town a little bit. Quick thing, I know when people pass or fail speech checks, or they fail trying to hack a terminal, they may reload a save and keep going until they get it. I'm not going to do that here. I'm just going to wing it. So if I fail a speech check, then I just fail it and I'm going to move on. If I screw up a terminal, then I just screwed it up. I'm going to move on. I think that'll make the game a little bit more interesting than, you know, constantly trying to reload. Because the truth is, even if you do miss a speech check or something, it's not the end of the world. So here we go. Let's get in here. See what Megaton has to offer.
Well, I understand. You're from that vault, Vault 101. I ain't seen one of those jumpsuits in a long time. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but I like you, boy. Something tells me you're all right. So welcome to Megaton. Just holler if you need something.
Clearly, this guy hasn't heard what I did to Silver. Anyway, nice town you got here, Sheriff.
Friendly and well-mannered.
Ooh.
I think we're going to get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like.
Stay anyway. All right, message received.
I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with?
I'm looking for my dad. Middle-aged guy. Maybe you seen him?
Nope. Sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor.
Damn.
I'd ask around town.
Alright, well, how about that gigantic bomb you have sitting down in the middle of your town? What's up with that?
What about it?
Don't you think someone should try to disarm the thing?
I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat.
Are they idiots?
And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? Do you think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good?
Well, I can see about disarming that thing for you if you like.
Oh, all right. Fine. But listen here. Just take a look at it first. Go easy. If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you.
So trusting. Come on, man. Demolition expertise doesn't come cheap. Give me 5.
Not an option, I'm afraid.
Damn.
We aren't exactly rolling in cash down here.
All right, fine. That works. I'll take a look at it.
Great. Go ahead and see what you can do. Just be careful.
So trusting. See anything else in here? You know anything about the area outside this place?
It's called the Wasteland for a reason. But
Duh.
There are settlements, too, spread all around. The human race is stubborn like that. To the south, you've got Rivet City. But don't bother going to D.C. The place is a war zone.
All right. Well, I gotta go now. Thanks, Sheriff.
Don't blow us up now.
I'll try.
Staying out of trouble, I hope.
Yeah, dude.
Don't fool around with that bomb unless you know what you're doing.
Man, leave me alone. The bomb in question is down there in the water. But we're not going to go down there first. We're going to swing around this way. This is the sheriff's house. I think once you deal with the bomb, this door might unlock. I can't remember. I usually end up lockpicking it, sneaking in, because there's a bobblehead in there that you definitely got to get to. But we're not going to do that right now. We're going to go this way. Tell you, the first time I came here, the first few times, as you can see, the town, the layout is just crazy. It took me forever to get a grasp on the geography of the place, the way everything, the pathways and all map out. I finally got it for the most part, but I still kind of get lost in the back. Really cool town, though. It's really, really great design.
What do you need?
Sup, old timer? I'm looking for my dad. What you know about that?
Could be the guy I saw at Moriarty's saloon not too long ago. I'd ask there.
Oh, okay. Was there anything I could do to help around here?
Well, it's no secret that the old water treatment plant is on its last legs. And I'm the only one in town that can keep the damn thing running. I spend so much time up in the plant that I can't take care of the leaks that keep springing up in the pipes around town. Now, I don't expect much from strangers.
You shouldn't.
But if you've got the know-how, I need someone to hunt down and repair those leaks.
Well, it's really easy to get a job in Megaton. Just come in and say you know something, and these guys are just dropping jobs at your feet. How many leaks are there?
From the pressure in the plant, my guess is that there are 3 of them scattered around town. Check along the pipes and the valves, but they might be a bit tricky to spot.
They're really not. All right, I'll keep it in mind.
I hope you can help. If folks knew how bad it was getting up here, well, I don't know what would happen.
All right, I gotta go now.
Well, back to work.
What work? You're sitting on your ass. Is it work to lean up on that? You holding the rail up? Is that your job? Lazy bastard. Hey, look. The Craterside Supply. Get used to seeing this place, folks. I'll be here often. Hey, what's up, old-timer?
Ah, look at this. New blood. Tell me, boy. You ever hear of the Enclave?
Enclave?
The last remnant of the good old USA they are. Now, I don't know you from Adam.
Nope.
But I got you pegged for a patriot. And any patriot worth his salt is gonna toss his gun in for the Enclave. Any day now, they're gonna roll up here, and then this nightmare will be over for good. But listen to me, Ramble. I'm Nathan. What can I do for you?
I think this guy may be a couple of fries short from a Happy Meal. Who are the Enclave?
They're the American government.
Really?
The Eagle. People comma weaver. The more perfect union.
Okay, why do you support them?
Why? Why? Look around you. This is the good old USA. Sure, she looks a little bit different these days, but you're still on American soil. And even if you were born in some underground vault,
hey.
You were born under the United States, which makes you an American. And it's your duty and my duty to support our country and our president, no matter what. Understand?
Let's see. At this point, I couldn't possibly care less about governments or presidents. Look around you, old man.
Well, we can't all care. Besides, why should we have to? That's what the government is here for, to take care of that stuff.
There is no government anymore. All right, I gotta go.
Take care.
A true patriot right there. And a little batshit into the bargain. Let's take a stop in here at Craterside Supply. Turn the light on.
Leave me out of that girl's crazy experiments. I don't get paid enough for that.
What? You get paid enough to lean against the wall. What is it with Megaton and guys holding up walls?
Hey, I hear you're that stray from the vault. Oh, I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you?
Sure, I got plenty I could say about that.
Great. Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life, or to come outside for the first time, or whatever strikes your fancy.
Well, it was paradise down there till Dad left.
A runaway dad, huh? I've seen plenty of them before, but none with the big 101 on their back. Good luck finding him. Maybe the armored vault suit will help you out there, huh?
Nice.
That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun.
What's the book?
Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the waste,
yeah.
Right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words.
What I'm about to do if you don't shut up? All right, I'll help you.
Good enthusiasm! Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which do you want to do first?
Tell me about this radiation.
Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it?
I don't know lots about it
from books, but I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning, so I can study its effects. Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that.
Okay. I'll do it. Just be ready to fix me up when I get here.
Oh, you're a peach. Or at least some sort of hardy fruit that grows in the savagely irradiated mockery of agriculture we have nowadays.
Oh my God.
Now, 200 rads should be enough for basic sickness. But if you can get 600 or more rads, my test will be even more accurate. Just make sure you can get back here, and I'll see to it that you're well taken care of.
Okay, will do. In the meantime, let's see what you have for sale. And here we have a new quest, the Wasteland Survival Guide. That's a really long one. Maybe the biggest quest in the entire game if you add in all of the individual things you have to do. So that one's going to definitely take a bit of our time over the next foreseeable few episodes as we whittle that away.
Absolutely.
All right, let's sell some of this excess stuff that I've got here. I'm going to get rid of that rifle. Don't worry, I've got a way to get another one that's even better. Get rid of these batons. Ran out of money here, but what I usually do when I get a merchant all the way down to nothing and take all of their money, I usually then go through their stuff and then just buy all the crap that they have that I want and kind of give them their money back and then sell more stuff. So I'll take those rounds, take those, I'll take the shotgun shells, take the 10mm rounds. Now she's got a little bit more money again. I saw she had some stim packs. I'm going to go ahead and get all of those. All right. Now that she has some more money, now I'll just continue to sell some more of this junk I don't need. Yeah, I'm not going to keep the baseball bat. I don't use a lot of melee weapons, so I'll keep the rifle. Don't care about the batons. Lots of stuff here to get rid of. All this raider armor I don't need. I don't want the reading glasses. I'll keep the tunnel snakes outfit just for shits and giggles. I'll get rid of the security armor. I'll keep the helmet, even though I hate it. I'll keep that. Okay. Let's see what else we got. Don't need the beer. Again, I'm saving these books for when I get the perk that doubles the amount of points you get per book. So hopefully I'll be reading those soon, but I definitely don't want to sell them. I save all the Nuka-Cola Quantum for a later quest. Let's see. So that's why I don't keep food. I just now got to Megaton and I've already got 30 stim packs. Like, that's why I never even bother with trying to keep food. I just keep these purified waters in case I find those homeless people or whatever wastelanders that beg for pure water. But that's it. Otherwise, I don't even use those. All right, let's see. I collect the pre-war money. I got a plan for that scrap metal soon. I collect those. Cherry bomb, lunchbox. And sensor modules are for the bottle cap mine, so I definitely need those. I think that's about everything. I'll get rid of these darts. I don't mess with the darts. I know a lot of people like to build the dart gun to use for death claws because it's an instant cripple when you hit them with a dart, but I don't even mess with that because by the time I get to death claws, my gun skills to a point where I really don't need to mess with all that stuff. I just take them on head up most of the time. And you can get a lot of money selling darts.
Good hunting!
Let's see. Alright, I think that's good. We'll go for now.
Take care.
See ya. Now, the quest for to get irradiated can happen really easily for anyone that may not have played this before. All you really got to do is just go right down there and stand next to that bomb and get as irradiated as you want. then come right back up here and talk to her. So that's another little quest that you can do right here in town, along with fixing the leaky pipes for the old man up there. All right, heading up this way to the saloon and see what we can find out about Dad. Lovely bathroom. Must be a public bathroom, I guess, the way it's just a random bathroom outside. Moriarty's Saloon. Here we go. What's going on over here?
My, my. Just when I had all but given up hope. My dear boy, I'm very happy to make your acquaintance. I am Mr. Burke. And you, well, you are not a resident of this putrescent cesspool.
Putrescent?
And makes you a rather valuable individual.
It does? If you got a point, come to it.
As you wish. I'm looking to employ an individual with no ties to Megaton, no interest in its future. Megaton is obsolete. The last vestige of a cobbled, desperate past. It needs to go away. And you are going to see that it does.
Wait, you're going to destroy the town?
No, no. I'm merely a recruiter. You get to have the real fun. The undetonated atomic bomb for which this town is named is still very much alive. All it needs is a little motivation. I have in my possession a fusion pulse charge. Once rigged to the bomb, it will be detonated by you at a secure location. Easy money, my friend.
Wow. Hey, throw in an extra caps and 500 caps and you get yourself a deal.
Is that the best you can do?
Damn you.
I'm afraid I'm not impressed.
Well, I wasn't actually going to blow it up anyway. I was just going to see if I could pass that speech check. You're out of your mind, dude. There's no way I'm helping you do that.
Now that is a disappointment. Well, if you change your mind, the offer still stands. Good day.
Come on, you piece of junk.
Mr. Burke. Let's see here.
Back again. Perhaps you've reconsidered my offer.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Excellent. I had a feeling about you. Here's the fusion pulse charge. It needs to be installed inside the bomb. When it's done, meet me at Tenpenny Tower. It's southwest of here, well out of harm's way. You can't miss it. Questions?
Nope, time for me to go.
Don't let me keep you.
It's the same damn thing.
Again, I have no intention of blowing up Megaton because it's my base of operations. I just want to get that fusion pulse charge so I can rat him out to Lucas Sims.
Son of a bitch. Wait, is that... Damn it. Stupid radio. Work.
Relax, dude.
Come on, Mark.
Hey, where are you going?
What do you need?
I'm looking for my father, middle-aged guy. Maybe you've seen him.
Yeah, I remember that man. I saw him talking to Moriarty. It's hard to forget handsome men like that.
Ooh, lady killer.
I'd love to spend time with you, too.
Yay, it worked.
Look, I can help you. Get into the back office of this place. Moriarty keeps a terminal there. Everything you want is inside the terminal. Here's the password to it. Too bad you're so young, kid. I could teach you some stuff you'd never forget.
Uh-oh. Hey, what's all this about Galaxy News Radio, anyway?
You serious?
Yeah.
Oh, you must have come from that vault, right. It's the only free radio station left in the wasteland. The guy who runs it, Three Dog, he's like the only person who seems to give a shit. He keeps talking about fighting the good fight or something. Better than the crap on the other station.
All right, maybe I have to swing by there and check out that radio station. All right, I gotta go.
Take care of yourself, hun.
Damn.
See what's going on with this ghoul over here.
Hey, Smoothskin, you need something? A drink, maybe? Anything? Anything at all?
Let me think about it for a moment, my good man.
Wait, you're not gonna hit me? Yell at me? Not even berate me a little bit?
The customers usually come in and punch you in the head. I hadn't planned on it.
Well now, that's a surprise. I'm used to every asshole smooth skin in this town giving me shit just because I look like a corpse. I'm glad to see that there are a few worthwhile people around here. Listen, Moriarty'd have my head if he caught me selling at a discount. But for you, I'll risk it.
Nice. Thanks. Where'd you come from, anyway?
A place called Underworld.
What?
It's a ghoul city down in D.C. I set off up here to find adventure and fortune. And, well, I found this place. I'm sort of stuck here. Colin says that I can't leave until I pay off my debt to him. Of course, he charges me room and board, too.
Wow.
If you ever get to Underworld, tell Carol that I said hi.
All right, I'll keep that in mind. It's always weird the way his voice changes when he reads that first line of dialogue. It's always strange. Now, what's the word around town?
I couldn't tell you, really. I'd talk to Manya if you care that much. She's lived in Megaton longer than anyone.
All right, goodbye, Gob.
Don't hit me! Okay.
Don't look at me like that.
Do you want something, or are you just looking to get your ass beat?
What's the matter? Never
it's
seen
locked
a ghoul
for
before.
A reason. Don't get any ideas.
We'll see about going into the back room through the back door here. Not really that I have to, but I always like to go ahead and pick this lock and get a little experience. Sometimes he's still sitting there. They never seem to really mind, so. There we go. Go, now we're hidden. He didn't notice me crawl across the room. He's like, oh, never mind. It must have been nothing. See what we have here. Check out visitors. Ah, James from Vault 101. So out of nowhere, James came back to Megaton. Since he stayed here before, he asked me where the hell he could get a lay of the land and find out what's going on in the world. I told him about Galaxy News Radio and the ruins of DC and that guy Three Dog. Then like that, he was gone again. So it looks like we need to find Galaxy News Radio to track down Dad. I'm going to go ahead and pick this while I'm sitting here. Even though I already have the password. Okay. Later, Colin. If you do that, I don't even have to deal with that guy. I hate Colin. Colin Moriarty's a jerk. So I usually just go that way to get the information I need and just
good
completely bypass him. Ooh. Whiskey wore off. I forgot I had that. I was drinking that. Alright. Now next, I believe somewhere over in this area, one of the leaks. There's a lot of buildings and houses in this town, the common house and things, but they don't really serve a lot of purpose other than to, you know, read some dialogue, but I'm not going to go crazy and spend a lot of time listening to NPCs talk if they don't advance the plot. So I'm going to get right to it and find those leaks that we have to fix. And then head down and get irradiated at the bomb. We also have to tell Lucas Sims that we got an offer to blow the bomb up. Don't want to forget about that. Where is that leak? There's that one over there. There's one leak. This is why I got my repair skill up a little bit. Right when we were leaving the vault, so we could do this quest.
There's one.
Our yeah. Side quest, I guess, you would be a better
something.
Way to describe it. That's the first time I've walked by that guy
Behold,
and he wasn't talking. There he goes.
He is coming with the cloud.
Here's the second leak. Two down, one to go. Third one is up there. There it is. I see it. I forgot how to get over there. I can never remember how to get to this third leak. I know I kind of get above it and then jump down on it. There we go. Woo! There. All leaks are fixed. We'll go back and speak to that old guy again. But first,
drink the waters of the...
We are going to get nice and irradiated.
For this ancient...
Oh.
...ancient weapon of war is our salvation. It is the very symbol of...
This is the quickest way to get it up to 600. Just sit here and just drink this irradiated water.
...as a reminder of the division that has occurred in the past, and the resplendence of the promise...
And once we get done with this...
...in the times to come...
I'll run back up to the top, talk to the old guy in the water treatment plant or whatever. Alright, thank you. I know I have radiation poisoning. Then go to Mora Brown, then get the next level of that quest. There's also a little side quest that you can do with a doc in this town. Doc Church, who is a huge jerk that I hate dealing with, but there's like a little side thing you can try to get with him where you learn a little bit of the secrets behind one of the other residents here at the town. Sometimes I can get that, sometimes I can't. Just depends on how high my speech or my medicine is. I can't remember, but I'm going to try it. It's a nice way to get some extra chems early on in the game, although it's not totally necessary. Almost there.
Shall know an end to pain, and shall know Atom in his glory.
I think that should be it.
My friends,
yep.
Come, drink.
Critical
with me
radiation
and pray.
Poisoning.
Glory.
Let's head back upstairs. We'll get back to Lucas and tell him what's up with Burke here in a minute. This is why I saved the scrap metal.
Yeah? What is it?
The pipes are all fixed.
Well, I'll be. The pressure's up in the plant. It looks like all the leaks have been fixed. Thank you, stranger. Thank you. But listen, it's only a matter of time before they burst again. And someone like you might not be around to fix them. I'll make you a deal.
What is it?
I'll give you caps for any scrap metal you can bring me. You'll find it all over the place out there in the waste. If I have a steady supply of scrap, I can keep the plant running and the pipe should be just fine. We got a deal?
All right, sounds good. I'll bring it to you.
Good. This just keeps looking better. Those parts will keep this place running and the town in fresh water. Hurry back as soon as you find some.
That's a really good side quest.
Huh? Yeah. What is it?
To gain caps and a lot of experience, because there's a lot of scrap metal around in this game. And you can unload it to this guy for infinity. At some point, I'll probably stop doing it because it actually makes me level up too fast. I end up like super overpowered, but early on, I will give him some scrap metal.
I sure am, Sonny. What have you got for me?
Just take all the scrap metal I've got.
Well, all right. Let me count out your caps.
You can see you've like five experience points for each piece of scrap metal. That would add up pretty quickly. So that's done. Let's go talk to Nutjob in here.
Oh, feeling a bit under the weather, or a bit over the Geiger counter?
I'm about as irradiated as I can get without burning a hole in the floor.
I can tell! You're positively glowing! Now, just hold on and try not to move. Tell me how it feels, and I'll get you fixed right up.
If you listen closely, I can hear my genes crying.
So, you're experiencing delusions, too. Fascinating. Now, after taking a few notes, I'll take care of that nasty radiation with a bit of my own homemade concoction.
Okay.
I've never had a chance to test it out on someone so heavily dosed, but I'm sure it'll work out fine. Exciting, isn't it?
It's something.
Okay. A little Brahmin milk, a couple magnets, and maybe a few happy thoughts. Well, you're alive! Ooh. Oh, that's the good news. But there was a little side effect. A teeny tiny, mutation. But it seems to be benign, at least. Here, take a few radiation chems, as my little way of saying, I'm sorry I twisted your DNA like a kitten with a ball of yarn.
Oh, gee, thanks. Rad regeneration perk added. Mora's experiment had an unexpected side effect. Now, when you suffer from advanced radiation poisoning, crippled limbs automatically regenerate. Okay. I mean, I guess it's a neat perk to have, but I've actually never benefited from it because I've never rarely ever get advanced radiation poisoning, and when I do, I don't have crippled limbs. So, I mean, it's cool to have. I'll take it. It's free, but I've never actually had to make use of that. All right, I'm ready to continue research on the first chapter.
I've got to see how safe it is to scavenge food from one of those huge stores out there. I need someone to research how to travel through a minefield. And that'll cover the first section of the book. Which strikes your fancy?
Getting food doesn't sound so bad. What are you looking for?
Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right? So they need a good place to find them. There's an old super-duper mart not far from here. I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it.
Okay, I'll check out the supermarket.
Oh, great! Food is most important, but see if you can get medicine, too. And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay?
Okay. All right, I gotta go.
Have fun out there, okay?
Oh, it's a blast. All right, now what? Let's see what I'm gonna do. Ooh.
What is it?
Nothing. What? What? Is that a hel- Oh, he's got a bandana on. I was like, what the hell? His hair looks like a helmet. All right.
Let's see if
I can get anywhere with this guy. I'm probably not. I probably can't because I'm probably not high enough yet. My skills.
What? I'm Doc Church, and I run this clinic. Now, before you go asking me for help, you'd better know the rules. Rule one, don't bother me. If you do bother me, you better be damn near dead. I'm busy enough taking care of people I actually like. Follow my rule, I'll keep you patched up, I'll keep getting paid, and we'll get along just fine.
God, I so hate this guy. Look, I think I may be addicted to something. I think I'm whiskey.
I can take care of it for you, for a price. That'll be 50 caps. Maybe the dent in your pocketbook will keep you away from that crap.
Just do it.
All right. I got some of this pre-war stuff. Should flush your system right out.
I'll be glad when I can get my own laboratory in my home so I don't have to keep paying people to do this for me, because I'm going to be addicted to stuff the entire game.
All better now, you big baby. Can I get back to work now?
There was something else I needed.
Well, speak up then. I don't have all day.
God, I hate this guy so much. So what do you know about the people here?
A doctor doesn't talk about his patients. At least not to strangers, he doesn't.
I'm only trying to help Doc.
Yeah, sorry. I don't think so.
Dang it. Hey, you can trust me. I'm a doctor myself.
Nice try. Maybe if you actually had some medical training, we could talk about it.
I didn't think I could get that one, but I tried.
Try not to hurt yourself.
We can come back to that one later.
Oh,
what's gonna happen? He's gonna... Hey, it's Jericho. Not you. One of our potential companions, but I'm not nearly evil enough to get Jericho right now. If you can get the doc, he will tell you about this guy's drug addiction.
Well, goddamn. You're new, right? Name's Leo Stahl. It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. Yeah.
Let's see if I can... Maybe I can get it out of him myself. And if you're able to convince Church to help you, he'll tell you that Leo here has a bit of a drug problem. But I miss those challenges, so I may be able to revisit them, though, later. Hey, who's in charge around here?
Well, Moriarty thinks he is. But Lucas Sims is the law around here, and everyone knows it.
All right, well, what do you do for fun around here, Leo?
Well, there's this and that.
Yeah?
I keep myself busy.
Uh-huh.
But really, that's none of your business, is it?
Huh, interesting.
Talk to you later, buddy.
All right, buddy. We'll get back to Leo later.
Women and
all right, time to get this thing going. Let's tell Lucas about Bert wanting me to blow up the town.
Staying out of trouble, I hope. Don't want to have to waste good bullets on your sorry hide.
Why are you talking to me like that, dude? I met a guy named Burke. He said he'd pay me to rig the bomb to blow up.
He said what? Oh, I never did like the look of him.
Oh. Yeah, he gave me this to rig the bomb. Take it.
Jesus, give me that thing.
My name's not Jesus.
Let's go find this Burke character. You're about to get an education in wasteland justice.
All right. Now, what I'm about to do here, know, it's probably not the most moral thing to do here, but it's the best way that I can think of to where I can get a Chinese assault rifle and a silenced 10mm pistol without actually getting my hands dirty and making everybody hate me. So this is what I usually do on most playthroughs. Hey, here he comes. Look at him running. Where'd he go? There he is. Come on, Slowpoke. I'm already here. Come on. There he goes.
A traveler, eh?
You there, Burke. Explain your business in Megaton.
I'm sorry. Sheriff, what are you hollering about?
You know damn well what I'm talking about. A bomb. You're trying to blow it up. Have you lost your goddamn mind?
Actually, he wants me to.
Sheriff, I'm afraid there's been a misunderstanding. Someone has surely been spreading rumors. I'll be sure to address the situation. Personally.
I'm placing you under arrest, Burke. At least until I figure out what the hell's going on around here.
And I'm afraid I won't be able to oblige your request, Sheriff. I have pressing matters to attend to. Now, step aside.
Uh-oh.
This isn't open to discussion. You're coming with me.
Why do you knuckle-draggers always insist on doing things the hard way?
Knuckle-draggers.
Very well, Sheriff. Lead the way.
Sorry, Sheriff, but I gotta let you take one for the team.
Oh.
And now I kill Burke. Oh, shit! I'm naked! Why do I not have clothes on? Where are my clothes?
Let it somehow get out of the floor. I just had to shoot Taylor!
Come on! This is frozen there. Burke has been killed. You can no longer receive a reward for blowing up Megaton. Guys, hold on a second. I had no idea. I was running around town completely naked. Well, except for my helmet. The helmet on my head. You know what? Never mind. I was naked. Alright. Sorry, Sheriff. I hate to have to do that, but I really want that nice Chinese assault rifle you got, and I really wanted Burke's silenced pistol. The suit's kind of nice, too. So I'm going to take that, and I'm going to take the hat. Sheriff, I'm going to take your rifle, your house key, and I'll take your clothes, too. I'm going to put on the fancy hat now. There. Now. There we go. Again, probably not the most moral way to go, but kind of amoral. Because, I mean, I didn't shoot him. But I did let him get shot. You know, welcome to the wasteland. Hey, Lucy.
I don't recognize you. New in town or something?
Sure am. Stopped in to find something to do.
I hope by something to do you mean a job. Otherwise you want to talk with Nova.
No, she got
I'm
jokes.
Looking for someone to make a delivery. Interested?
Sure, why not?
Great. I'd like you to deliver this message to my family in the Arafu settlement. I haven't heard from them in months, and
Arafu.
I'm worried.
Arafu,
as
huh?
soon as you get there, talk to Davis West. He'll be glad to pay you for the trip.
Okay, well, can you give me some information about Arafu?
Sure. Be glad to, since you're doing me a big favor and
new
all.
New quest, Blood Ties. Where is it?
Arafu is northwest of Megaton, on an old overpass over the Potomac. If you follow what's left of the river, you can't miss it.
Okay, do you suspect your family's in danger or something? What's going on?
No, not really. Maybe my letters just aren't arriving. Whatever you can do to get it there would sure be appreciated.
Okay, who else lives there?
Well, let's see. There's Evan King. He's like the sheriff of the town or whatever.
Okay.
Then there's my family, the Ewer family. And a lady who lives alone named Karen Shenzi.
Shenzi? Is there anything dangerous around there I should know about?
What? Apart from the wasteland critters, slaver raiding parties, raider hit squads, and occasional landmine? No, it's completely safe.
Point taken.
If this was easy, I'd go myself, you know.
Point taken. Let me ask you something else.
Oh.
Psych, I gotta go.
Hey, thanks again for doing this for me. It means a lot.
Welcome to Moriarty's Saloon.
Don't mention it, complete stranger. I just met and have no idea
just
about.
Looking to get your ass beat.
Okay. Let me save. I think it's time to disarm that bomb. gonna take the shortcut here and just jump off the buildings like Spider-Man.
There shall be no tears. No.
Attempt to disarm the bomb. You have successfully disarmed the bomb. That was easy. Since Lucas Sims has died, now we have to report to his son to let him know that we've disabled the bomb and to get our reward. I don't know where he is, though. Let me make sure the quest is marked. He wanders around a lot. Look at all the quests we've picked up here in Megaton. Okay, let's see.
Evening.
Burned from you in the fire.
Says he's this way. Maybe he's walking around somewhere. Where you at, you little brat? Nope, is that him right there? Yep, that's him over there. It'd be easier for me to get to him. This way? Where the hell did he go? Oh, is he up there? Crap, went the wrong way. This is what I mean. I struggle to find my way around in here sometimes. Hey, kid.
You did it! You disarmed that thing! My dad! He would have been real happy about that. Thank you. He wanted you to have these. A key and the deed to an empty place up behind the brass lantern. You can move in there if you want. Oh, and talk to Mora at Craterside Supply. She can help you decorate the place.
Outstanding. Thanks, kiddo. And I think we just leveled up. We did! Alright. Let's go ahead and increase a few things here. I'll leave the lockpick at 25. I'll bump up my speech a little bit. Let's see, medicine's kind of low. Boost that up just a bit more. Okay. Actually, let's back that down just a taste. There we go. So I'd like to get that up to at least 30. I like nice round numbers. There we go. Let's see, what do we want here? Here we go. Comprehension. With the comprehension perk, you gain one additional skill point whenever a book is read. I go ahead and get that because that does make a little bit of a difference over the long run, but it's not such a huge thing to where it makes you level up way too fast. One that we won't be taking is Educated. Now, I used to get this every time, but that was when I wanted to level up faster. This is the way to go. You want to get this early on if you want to level up fast your skills. But like I mentioned before, I don't. I want to take my time and continue to be improving my character over the course of all these quests during the Let's Play. So I'm actually going to skip the Educated perk. I don't want to turn into a Terminator too quick. But I will do Comprehension because that little bit of boost I can appreciate. And it allows me to use these books here, get them out of my inventory. Like Chinese Army Spec Ops Training Manual. Now sneaks increased by 2 instead of 1, etc. Duck and cover. What else we got? Pugilism Illustrated. Although I don't really use unarmed that much, I'll take it. Let's visit our new house. Alright. Wadsworth.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Wadsworth, your personal robotic butler.
Wadsworth.
I am here to look after your needs and to keep you happy and entertained. What can I do for you?
Sweet. I'd like something to drink.
Certainly, sir. Here you are.
Sweet. Tell me a joke.
A neutron walks into a bar. How much for a drink here, anyway? To which the bartender responds, for you, no charge.
Oh, God, I gotta get out of here.
Of course, don't let me keep you.
Oh, I won't. All right, here we go, guys. This is our base of operations here. And this is my main home throughout every time I play these games, so I'll take this food out. I'll eat it just to get rid of it, because I usually just keep my Nuka-Cola Quantums in the fridge over there, so I don't have to carry it around. Well, and in these, I usually keep extra weapons and armor that I don't want to get rid of, that I don't want to sell. that I kind of want to keep. Like, I'll keep the sheriff's duster in there, the tunnel snake suit. I'll keep these. The jumpsuits. Yeah, leave all that stuff there. Just keep this. I also keep weapons in there as well. But I don't really have anything that I want to drop off in there yet. And over here, I like to keep ingredients for the stuff that I build. Mostly the bottle cap mines. So I need to put up my tree bomb, lunch box, sensor module. I'll keep that sheet music on me. So this is downstairs.
Very nice to meet you.
Going upstairs.
I'm your new robot.
This is... Wadsworth's just talking to himself. In this room, this is where I keep all the money. And I don't do anything with it. I just drop it on the floor. Sounds weird, but later on, when you come in this room, and you have this room with the floor completely covered with cash, it's oddly satisfying. I have no idea why, so that's what I do. I just pick up all the pre-war money and just throw it on the floor here. A few hours from now, the floor of that room's going to look pretty awesome. You know, dilapidated, crappy room there. Some more dilapidated, crappy stuff there. Alright. So now we got a new place. We got several quests here. The main stuff here, as far as the individual quests that you can do right inside a Megaton, are done. As far as fixing the leaks and the short one for Mora Brown. Now the quest that we have left, except for the one with Doc Church that I'll come back to later, all involves us leaving town and venturing out into the wasteland. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go to Super Duper Mart. We're going to continue on with the Wasteland Survival Guide quest and find the Super Duper Mart. See if we can find medicine and food in there. So that is where we're going to pick up next time, folks. Thanks again for watching. If you liked the video, please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Later.